everyone. I am Shrinika Vettan, the assistant professor in RPIIT Technical and Medical Campus. Today, I am here with all of you to discuss my another topic, that is drugs that are used in the management of COPD or COPD. So, what is COPD? What does we understand with this term? It is basically chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, and the airflow is obstructed during expiration. This increases the work of breathing and causes dyspnea, and in contrast to asthma, the airflow obstruction is not reversible. So in asthma, the air obstruction is reversible, but in this case, the air obstruction is not reversible and usually progress over time and time. There are several mechanisms of airflow and obstruction in the COPD. Chronic bronchitis results in a hypersecretion of mucus, which fills and obstructs the airway lumen. Beta 2 agonists and anticholinergic drugs are used in COPD. The bronchodilator esterase, two main types of bronchodilators that come in inhalers. There is anticholinergics and next is beta 2 antagonist. So beta 2 agonist includes salbutamol, terbutaline, formoterol, salmeterol and indacterol. And anticholinergics include ipratropium bromide, tiotropium, clegopyronium and adenalum. Next are antitussives. The cough reflex occurs when the receptors in the airway send impulses to the brainstem and causes the contraction of muscles needed to cough. The type of cough produced depends upon the stimulated receptors and whether or not the mucus is brought up with the cough. Pharyngeal, demulcent, lozenges, cuff, lingeus containing syrup and glycerin. The second is expectorant, that is also called as mucokinetics, includes bronchial secretion enhancers, sodium or potassium citrate, balsam of Tolu. The third one is mucolytics, that includes ambroxol, acetylcysteine. Antitussives are the main cough center suppressants, and they include opioids, codeine, folocodine, non-opioids, noscapine, dextromethorphan, antihistamines, chlorpheniramine, adjuvant antitussives. The next is demulcents and expectorants. Pharyngeal demulcents soothe the throat and reduce efferent impulses from the inflamed, irritated pharyngeal mucosa, thus provide symptomatic relief in dry cough arising from throat. Expectorants that includes mucokinetics are the drugs believed to increase bronchial secretion or reduce its viscosity, facilitating its removal by coughing. Mucolytics, bromhexine, a derivative of the alkaloid pessine obtained from Adhortada vexia vesica, is a potent mucolytic and mucokinetic capable of inducing the copious bronchial secretions. Antitussives, they act centrally by suppressing the neurons located in the brainstem's cuff center. Antitussives are often used with tracheitis, tracheobronchitis, and when coughing worsens the inflammation that is already present and stimulates more coughing, it's need to be pressed or suppressed. Next is the antitussives basically act centrally, and they work by holding a message in the brainstem cuff center. So these are all about our antitussives. In my next video, I will discuss about the demulcent and expectorant. I hope you all understood well. Thank you.